sweet to be an idiot, as harmless as a cloud, too small to hide the sun, almost poking fun at the warm but insecure, untidy crowd. Sweet to be an idiot and dip my brain in joy, children laughing at my back with no fear of attack, as much retaliation as a toy. How sweet idiot, how sweet. I tiptoe down the street, smile at everyone I meet. The outlook for today is mainly tragic. Cloudy, dull, occasional rain and scattered magic. But unlike those who say they prefer the good old days, I hardly ever feel nostalgic. And although the intellectually agile can logically prove the heart is fragile, drifting unawares through all of its affairs, nevertheless, love is still the simple badge I'll proudly wear. When does a dream begin? Does it start with a good night kiss? Is it begun when two hearts are one? When does a dream begin? When does a dream begin? Is it born in a moment of bliss? Is it conceived or simply achieved? When does a dream begin? The vision of you appears somehow impossible to resist. But I'm not imagining seeing you now, for who could have dreamed of this? When does a dream begin? When reality is dismissed? Or does it commence when we lose all pretense? When does a dream begin?
In among the silver birches, winding ways of tarmac wander, and the signs to Bussock Bottom, Tussock Wood, and Windy Break, gabled lodges, tile-hung churches, catch the lights of our Lagonda as we drive to Wendy's party. Lemon curd and Christmas cake, rich the makes of motor whirring, past the pine plantation purring, come up Hupmobile Delage, short the way your chauffeurs travel, crunching over private gravel, each from out his warm garage. Oh, but Wendy, when the carpet yielded to my indoor pumps, there you stood, your gold hair streaming, handsome in the hall light, gleaming. There you looked, and there you led me off into the game of clumps. Then the new Victrola playing, and your funny uncle saying, choose your partners for a foxtrot, dance until it's 3 o'clock, come on, young'uns, foot it featly. Was it chance that paired us neatly? I who loved you so completely, you who pressed me closely to you, hard against your party frock. Meet me when you finished eating. So we met, and no one found us. Oh, that dark and furry cupboard, while the rest played hide and seek, holding hands, our two hearts beating in the bedroom silence round us, holding hands and hardly hearing sudden footstep, sudden shriek, love that lay too deep for kissing. Where is Wendy? Wendy's missing. Love so pure, it had to end. Love so strong that I was frightened when you gripped my fingers tight and, hugging, whispered, I'm your friend. Goodbye, Wendy. Send the fairies, pinewood elf and larch tree gnome. Spingle spangled stars are peeping at the lush Lagonda creeping down the winding ways of tarmac to the leaded lights of home. There, among the silver birches, all the bells of all the churches sounded in the bath waste, running out into the frosty air. Wendy speeded my undressing. Wendy is the sheets caressing. Wendy bending gives a blessing. Holds me as I drift to dreamland, safe inside my slumberware.
We're closed on Christmas Day, aren't we, Jim? And Christmas Day in the zoo is probably one of the loneliest days for the animals, because we come to see them, but, you know, they do wonderfully miss us, don't you, Jimmy James? Because
yes.
There's nobody here on Christmas Day, and just as much as we like looking at things and animals, they love looking at human beings.
Well, yes, of course.
Now, Jimmy James here is an orangutan. Look at him. He's 6 years old. You may think he looks a bit dumb, but he isn't, you know. He knows quite a lot,
yes.
Don't you, Jim? You know a lot.
Nothing what to make of us. We wonder why they wear their mats. They smile at you. Funny things, hats, aren't they?
Yeah, I don't think that fits you, Jim.
No, I don't think it does.
Big Ed got this hat.
Yes, I think he is a bit of a big Ed. What's it saying? It's like 7 1/4. Bloody hell. I'm only 6 7/8, I think.
You're not, Jimmy. You must be 8 1/2.
Get out of it, 8 1/2.
Yes, you are, Jim. You know you're funny about hats, don't you?
Don't understand why people wear them. I really do not understand why people wear them. They're very nice to have a look at. And, of course, your head smells funny.
My head smells funny? Heads don't smell funny, Jimmy James.
Oh, yes, they do.
Do they really?
Yes. Everything smells a bit funny.
Does it really?
Well, human beings smell funny.
Well, you know, orangutans smell a bit funny too.
It's all a part of man's wonderful conceit. He got to dress himself up and put something on it. Put something on his head. Sort of to crown himself. Who do they think they are, eh? Cool. No, I don't know.
There's no doubt about it. Orangs are very high in the intelligence rating as far as I'm concerned.
That's right, mate.
Jimmy James has got this hat of mine, and he wants to find out how it's made. And he's going to find out. Bit by bit, he'll take it apart. As we do life, take it apart, try and find out how it's made and what it's made of.
Yes, that's very, very succinct, what you said.
What I said, Jim?
You said it was succinct.
Oh, very well.
Right, this is a lullaby. Mommy's 20-something. Daddy's over 30. Go to sleep, my baby, and don't do that, it's dirty. Thank you. singing a song is easy, watching the world go by. If you were a song, I'd sing you, but you're more than meets my eye. So let's sing a song together, just like holding hands. Simple words and music, we can all understand. As you love yourself, so I'd like to wish you everything that I would wish myself. Someone to care for you, someone to fall in love, someone to raise your voice to, maybe someone.